welcome to the best of Vegas from the 2008 MLG Pro Circuit. Las Vegas was host to our invitation-only national championships where the top eight Halo teams were here vying for the coveted title of 2008 MLG champion. Now with $280,000 up for grabs, all the teams came here to do fierce battle. Now we picked the best matches for you to enjoy.
That's right, Farouk, and let's go ahead and just kick it off with this first one. It's between two bitter rivals who have not met each other since MLG Toronto. We're gonna check out Final Boss facing off against Instinct in this amazing game one, Capture the Flag on Narrows.
Now, what was it like just beating the team that gave you the boot a few weeks ago?
It was like taking candy from a baby, but wait, whoa, let me finish. But I think the baby would put up a better fight.
Ah. All right, so bad blood obviously between Walshy and the Ogres, but.
That's definitely gonna be one of the most memorable parts of 2008 for me. I mean, how could you not forget that one right there, gentlemen?
And you know, well, Sundance, while it was hilarious in Toronto, there has been no taking candy from babies here in Las Vegas for Instinct. It's been a hard-fought battle. And you know what? Final Boss is going to be looking for redemption here. We got our loser's bracket round three. Final Boss facing off against Instinct. And you know, Final Boss, they're going to come out swinging. We got to take a look at their rosters here. We got Ogre One. He's going to, oh, we're checking out Instinct right now. We got Lunchbox and Roy, the two twin brothers, and of course, Team Captain Walshy down in the bottom left, and Soviet, a guy who has been playing out of his mind all tournament long. He's on fire.
Yeah, and you know, the keys to success, we've talked about it yesterday, is the same. Those twins need to keep on playing on fire, need to do what they're known to do. Soviet has stepped it up. He's got to keep that up. And you know, they got to do what they've been doing, which is winning some team slayers. They do as well as they always have on the objectives. They're fine. They're playing much better on the team slayers, which is a great sign if you're an Instinct fan.
And then, of course, their opponent is going to be the number three seeded team coming into the event. It's going to be Final Boss. They're wearing red. Check them out. Led by team captain Ogre One, strong side. Ogre Two, and the player who's been keeping the rest of the guys in the game, it's been Neighbor, and he's been phenomenal so far.
Yeah, he really has. An incredible player. Saw him stepping it up yesterday. I expect to see more of that today. Now, their keys to success, consistent play from Ogre One and strong side. We saw them step it up yesterday. They need to continue to do so. The winningest twin duo in the history of the league, that's Ogre One and Ogre Two. If these guys dominate, it's bad news for anyone else. Killer Instinct. That means just put your opponent down. If you have the opportunity, put your boot on their throat and put them out. And finally, execute. These guys play the game the way they're able to. They're going to be tough to beat.
All right, Sundance. Well, I don't want to wait any longer. Let's get right into it, Las Vegas. Here we go. We're jumping into game one. Capture the Flag on Narrows. Of course, the first team to score three times is going to win the game. And of course, there's going to be some snipers. There's going to be some rockets. A little mauler up top. I can't wait to see who is going to get the sniper for Final Boss. And I got a feeling it's going to go to this guy. We're checking out Neighbor. And of course, we got Neighbor with the sniper. He's going for the rocket as well. So fully loaded is Neighbor. And he's going to pick up a kill on Lunchbox and grab the Instinct sniper. But no, he's taken down. And right now, I'm going to jump on board with Lunchbox, or Walshy, rather, from Instinct. He's got the rockets. And Walshy's got the rockets now at the opponent's base. Walshy in the opponent's base, but two of his teammates are getting shot at back at home. Walshy shooting long-range rockets all the way across the map. Doesn't pull the flag. Smart move there. Wait until your teammates are in position and also come back and help get them out of that spawn trap. Great move here. That is a sign of an experience on this.
Definitely. Walshy, again, you know, one of the most selfless players on the circuit. This guy will do whatever it takes. Just like we saw him have a game where he had 15 assists because he knows what to do. It's about getting your teammates in a position where they can do the most damage. Walshy right now, staying alive, playing smart, gotta like this as a start for.
And you know, Walshy came back there, Sundance. He helped out his teammates, and that allowed them to pick up two sniper rifles. So you got the rockets and the flag in the hands of Walshy momentarily. Meanwhile, Soviet, he has the sniper, and so does this guy. It's Roy, the guy who put up 21 kills in a team slayer last night on ESPN Saturday night. And right now, he's got the sniper rifle, watching his own man cannon side, waiting for his teammates to spawn and come up and help him top middle.
There's two guys
Good job staying alive right there. Right now, it seems like these teams, you know, kind of feeling each other out, trying to get a rhythm for the game. Obviously, you know there's a lot of pressure down there. Nobody wants to overextend themselves and allow an easy flag cap because momentum is going to be huge in this series. The team that believes they can win is just going to have that mental advantage.
That's right, and we saw the opening surge coming from Final Boss. They pushed all the Instinct back in their base. Walshy came and saved the day, got them out of that spawn trap, but now it's Instinct's turn to put the pressure back on FB as they're pushing up with the power weapons, and Roy is doing damage all the way across the map, picking up the double kills with the sniper here. Walshy's got the flag moving towards the man cannon, something we don't really see out of Instinct. Normally they love to run the flag bottom middle, and Walshy is going to go with a matchmaking trick, tossing the flag over the man cannon side. We're jumping on board with Lunchbox. So Lunchbox trying to get to that flag, but he's going to get chased down by the ogres. We're just going on board though with Neighbor right now. He's got a sniper rifle here for Final Boss, as Final Boss is going to be able to get that flag return at Instinct's base. And Walshy getting caught by Neighbor. Nice job by Neighbor. Good awareness. Didn't see anyone top middle. Knew someone must have been sneaking down low. And he is not missing right now with this sniper, picking up a big headshot there on Roy. And now it's Final Boss's turn for a flag attempt. So we got the flag moving in the hands of Ogre 2. Neighbor locking down the man cannon side. He just picked up one kill, jumping off the sniper. That was a very heads-up move there. We're jumping on board with Ogre 1 here, trying to keep the flag alive, but it looks like Instinct is going to be able to return it back to their base.
Again, neither team really able to get into a rhythm there. You saw the flag was pulled, it was bottom mid, but a good job by Instinct not to freak out. You see now Walshy.
Walshy's got the flag out, but Ogre 1 was at the Instinct's base. So Ogre 1 didn't pull the Instinct flag. Instead, he's going to sit here, and he's going to go for the flag return. He's got to watch out for players on man cannon side. It's Roy, though, and strong side with a perfect grenade is going to be able to take down Roy. Two members were down momentarily there for Instinct, and now it looks like Final Boss is going to try and push into that Instinct base. But Instinct, they're just being a pain in the butt. It's like what they did against Straight Rippin' in this Pit CTF game. They're going to stay and keep pulling your flag, keep you guessing where they're coming from.
Again, because people are so concerned, the flag's out, you have to put all of your attention towards stopping that cap. And Instinct's really great at disrupting other teams' momentum. They're just sneaky about it. And you look right now, Walshy running a flag down low.
It's been about 4 minutes, 30 seconds, Sundance. I think we've seen 6 flag pulls out of Instinct already. Two of them, which they got all the way back to their base
and
on man cannon
like this
side.
One. Oh, a little fumble there, but there you go.
But there we go.
First cap of the game. Instinct right now, you hear the crowd going and crazy.
Soviet's drinking water.
He's just chilling out.
He's comfortable right now.
It's dry in the desert, baby. You got to stay hydrated.
Gotta love it.
He's cool, man. So, I don't know how he does it.
All right, well, let's jump back into the game. I want to check out what's going on with Final Boss. We're going to go take a look at Neighbor. Right now, he's working pretty well here with Ogre 1, trying to move up top middle. He saw a player going towards man cannon
and
side.
I like that play. Not firing a shot. He knows where he needs to go. He calls out the location of the opponent. Very heads-up play right there.
And now Sundance, something I want to talk about, something we didn't really cover in the keys to success for Final Boss, is communication. When we see Final Boss lose, what happens is they stop communicating. It seems they get frustrated, and instead of calling out locations, they start complaining.
Well, I think, you know, one of the things is it's also tough. I mean, you got to give Bravo props. He's very excitable. He gets into the games. But the thing is, look down. He's coaching two legends. I mean, it's like you got two Michael Jordans on the squad, and you're trying to coach these guys. These guys, you know, a lot of people just don't know how to communicate to them. So I think sometimes that, you know, is a factor, honestly, because he's got to bark out orders. And when they stop talking, if he can light that fire underneath them, it seems like, as we saw yesterday when they got quiet, suddenly he got in there and then Neighbor stepped it up and they responded. So I think you're right. They got to keep talking no matter what. They can't get down on themselves, which they've been guilty of a few times this season.
All right. Well, right now it looks like the Ogre 1 and Neighbor combo are going to be taken down top middle. Meanwhile, Instinct, they're doing big things. We're jumping on board with Soviet. He just picked up a huge headshot on Ogre 2 there with the sniper. Now he's turned around, almost caught strong side with one, and now he's running back to the Final Boss base, but he's going to get chased down. We're jumping on board with Roy. He's got a sniper trying to stay alive at the Final Boss base. Meanwhile, his twin brother Lunchbox is right in the same position with him, but Lunchbox has got the rockets to work with.
Wow.
So here we
great
go.
Great switch out there by the twins.
And you know, next he said, I asked him, who was it in that game five who really stepped it up? All four players were playing well, but he said it was the twins, the twin brothers, and especially this guy, Roy, who really caught fire. Let's jump on board, though. Actually, I'm going to stay on board with Roy right here. You see Walshy there on his R1. Two of his teammates dead, so he's going to hold back, get Roy a perfect spawn top middle, and now they're going to push together. Heads up play from Walsh.
Yeah, so much of the game is about that thinking ahead, knowing where you're going to spawn your teammates, and trying to set yourself up for a run. Four down now for Final Boss. Instinct is doing a great job.
And here we go. We got a flag out in the hands of Lunchbox. And here we go. We're going to Lunchbox's screen. Meanwhile, Roy and Walshy, they're back at their base. They're going to try and give Lunchbox some cover. Lunchbox got the flag really far, so we're going to see if they can capitalize on it. Let's go on board with Lunchbox's twin brother. He's doing a lot of damage top middle, but Ogre 2 is going to shut him down. Walshy stays alive, though, and so does the flag. Finally, Final Boss being able to make that return. But I really thought right there, Sundance, that Instinct had a great opportunity to score a second flag.
It looked like it, but again, you know, Final Boss sticking to their game plan. When the flag's out, remember, every time that Instinct pulls the flag and gets it across the map, it's also a disruptor. So it's time that Final Boss isn't spending focusing on capping, they're focusing on returning their flag. So that's part of Instinct's gameplay style. They just keep you off balance.
All right, well, here you're watching Walshy here, but right next to him, we got Roy picking up double kills, and I'm going to Lunchbox. He's got the sniper rifle. And Lunchbox has got the sniper here, top middle. Soviet's moving down low. And Lunchbox, he's going to take heavy fire from Neighbor, and he's got to jump the sniper rifle off or hit Neighbor in the belly with it.
30.
You know, I thought Lunchbox for sure was dead. Neighbor was chasing after him. He wanted that sniper rifle. But Lunchbox poked out and caught him in the stomach. And now he's raining fire down from across the map. There he's on a killing spree. We got another flag moving in his twin brother's hands. It's Roy. And now Lunchbox moving towards the man cannon side, trying to give him more cover. All four members of Instinct alive, but all four members of Final Boss are as well. And they were, you were checking out as the flag was trying to move in the hands of Soviet. And Soviet's got the flag moving towards his man cannon, and here he goes. If he could get this over, this could be huge, as Lunchbox is in the Final Boss base, picking up big double kills. But I do not think this one is coming back. We're going to jump on board with Neighbor, actually. Oh! He picks up the beatdown. He's got the flag return. That was clutch because he had no shield, Sonny.
That was big time. That's Neighbor at his best. That's what he does. He comes up with amazing plays like that. His reaction time off the charts.
All right, well, Neighbor actually seemed to really struggle except for that huge move so far. I want to check out what is going on with Final Boss, what's going wrong with their game so far, and what can they do to turn it around. Nice teamwork there by the Ogres and Neighbor pushing up as a threesome. Soviet's got the sniper down low, so Neighbor's just going to put a shot on him and ignore. Meanwhile, it looks like it's 30 seconds until the new sniper rifle's coming up. So it'll be interesting to see whether Final Boss goes for a flag cap or if they go for the setup and trying to get the new power weapons. And Ogre 2's going to take down Soviet. Ogre 1 is there to protect Neighbor. Neighbor waiting for a shield to come back. Here's Lunchbox. Oh. Lunchbox with a clutch kill
Lunchbox
here.
Lunchbox just stepping it up so far, having a great game.
And we're going to Ogre 2 right now because he's the only one alive, and he's got to stop this Instinct rush because they got the flag going out. It's Walshy once again. Oh, but Walshy gets stuck here, and it looks like Roy, the only player in position to go back for that flag, but I think Ogre 1's getting the flag return right now. So Final Boss, they've had their flag out at least 10 times here Sundance, but time and time again, they're able to step it up one player at a time, and someone is going clutch. Who do you want to check out?
I'd love to see Ogre 1. Well, we got him right now. He's over here. He's doing some damage. You're smart like that. You know me really well. But I'm an easy read. I'm not that complicated. If they're going to have a shot at winning this event, I think Ogre 1's a player that I'm going to key on because he's got to really go off. He's got to show us that, you know, he's at the top of his game and he's in his groove. If he's able to do that, then that's going to motivate his brother. It's going to motivate Strongside. And, you know, he's got the ability. We've seen him do it, you know, year after year. Right now, all four dead for Final Boss, but Instinct not in a position to do much. But every time Instinct's pulling the flag, remember, it's a disruption of strategy for Final Boss. And Final Boss right now, other than one time, has failed to get the flag past the halfway point on the map.
That's right. And so Final Boss really going to have to step it up here. They're going to have to start working as a team better. They're going to have to actually start slaying. Right now, I'm seeing they're getting outslayed.
I'm seeing Roy pick up double kills over and over again. Those kills are being supported by Soviet and Walshie, always distracting here in the top middle. Meanwhile, Lunchbox, he was doing some dirty with the sniper, but so is this guy. Neighbor is heating up right now, Sundance.
This
he just killed a member, grabbed his sniper rifle, and now he's got 9 more shots to work with. Here's Walshie, top middle, 2 no-scopes. Oh, and Walshie clutched
it
there.
Play out of Walshie right there.
And Walshie's going to get fired up after that. A little bit of a choke there on Neighbor's part. We're going back on board with Lunchbox once again inside the final boss base. How are they able to just keep sneaking in?
Because they're sneaky beavers.
Well, it looks like Ogre One, he's not so anti-stealthy either. He's got a flag out. Anti-stealthy, put that one in your dictionary.
He wears sneakers.
All right, here's Ogre 2 versus Lunchbox. Huge BR win there for Ogre 2. So Walshie went in a big BR battle. Now it was Ogre 2's turn, and Neighbor, he's going to try and keep the flag alive. You see him pushing it back towards his teammate top middle. Now he's going to push in with the rockets. And final boss is going to be putting this one in. We're jumping on board with Ogre 1. He's taking fire. Oh. He stopped short. Strong side going for it. He's going to be stopped, but Ogre 2 is there to put it in. Tied up 1-1.
And that's with just 2 minutes left in regulation. Huge play out of final boss. Clutch. They're able to execute, get the flag across, and now they've got another flag out.
Yeah, Neighbor's running the flag right now. And we're going to jump on board with him. He's actually being taken down. We're going to strong side. Strong side, last member alive for final boss momentarily. He's going to keep the flag alive. Huge play by strong side. Perfect timing, waiting for his overshield and his opponent to leave. Neighbor's down here, down low. He's got to stop Walshie. And Walshie, once again, able to do a lot of damage. But there is Ogre 2 and Instinct. They're going to keep the flags alive. So the final boss flag out, but it's not far. Ogre 2 trying to get the return from above, but the flag is moving behind him towards the man cannon. No, Roy's running it bottom middle. We're jumping on board with Roy.
Oh my
goodness.
He's
taking heavy fire from behind. Oh. He's going to be taken down. Lunchbox's twin brother trying to keep it alive. And Neighbor's clutch once again.
Whoa. They were so good.
I'm out of breath. It's so insane. I can't believe the amount of action, the amount of back and forth momentum pushes we've been seeing. Oh, my Neighbor just barely seeing the top of his opponent's head and catches Walshie with a nice headshot there from the sniper rifle. All three of his teammates moving in. A big double kill there from Ogre 2, picking up an assassination and then out BRing Soviet. And that is going to be 3 down. Make it 4 down here for Instinct. Here comes Walshie, and Neighbor continuing to do the damage. Ogre 1 cleaning it up. But the flag is still out, but no one is moving it. And we're
gotta
jumping.
Be careful of the counter cap here.
Yeah. And there we have it. Instinct shutting down that one. Lunchbox, he's picking up some kill joys, and now it's going to be Instinct's turn. Like he just said, final boss had to be careful of the counter cap. Instinct attempted it, but nice play there by Strongside to take him down. And check out the stick from Soviet.
Oh, that was nasty.
Soviet clamping plasma grenades onto Ogre One's ankles, and now he's picking up a beatdown on Strongside. No shield, pushes into the sniper. He is playing extremely aggressive right now. And great awareness. And yes, we are past the 15-minute mark, so it is sudden death. The next flag will win the game.
See some fresh rockets in Lunchbox's hands.
And Roy's got a sniper top middle, so 2 power weapons for Instinct. Walshie is alive to protect as well. Walshie actually sitting back at his base trying to do some defense because Strongside and friends are in that area.
Are you kidding me?
Strongside is going to get BR'd by Soviet back at his base. The flag still alive in Walshie's hands. There's one member alive on the map for final boss, and this is going to be it. No one in position to stop Walshie, and the Walshie champ begins as Instinct takes game. Game one here.
It was. Soviet. Did you see that dirty, Farouk? That was insane. He's 3 players engaging with him. Shields down, wins 2 battles, able to keep the flag alive. That was just insane.
Instinct goes on to win the series 3-1, sending Final Boss home with a 4th place finish, their lowest national championship finish ever. And after the game, Neighbor tosses his controller into the crowd, signifying the end of the Final Boss season.
That's right, Farouk. Tough break there for Final Boss. But this next game is coming from the winner's bracket finals between the number one seed Straight Rippin' and, believe it or not, the seven-seeded Carbon. Now, no one thought Carbon could make it this far, but here they were standing toe-to-toe with the giant Straight Rippin'. Make sure you check out this amazing Game 2 Team Slayer on Amplified. It's one for the ages.
All right, if you're hearing my voice, you want to get back in front of your screen right now. Carbon is up over Straight Rippin', 1-0 in the winner's bracket finals. We got it all going down right here, right now in Las Vegas. We are live. Let's get ready for this Team Slayer game, Game 2.
Yeah, that's right, Farouk. Here we go. It is time for Straight Rippin' to shine. And one player who did it last night for them was legit in this Game 5 versus Instinct. Let's see if they can do it again here, this time against Carbon. And of course, we're going to be starting this game off with the player who went absolutely nuts, putting up a big 17 kills last night. We're kicking off with legit. And now, of course, this is the Halo 3 Winners Bracket Finals coming at you live on MLG Championship Sunday. But on our B stream, guys, right now we have Call of Duty, some of the hottest matches in that game going on simultaneously. MLG bringing you the best of the best in gaming. And right now we are checking out as Carbon opens up with a 4-1 lead over Straight Rippin', picking up four of the opening kills. But Straight Rippin', you know, they are known to rally back and to rally back quickly.
But you know what? I think this is the most important time in the match of Amplified TS. You got to win the break. You got to jump out to an early lead and force the other team to try to catch up to you. The break is so important.
All right, well, we'll see who can take advantage of the opening break here. And it's a 9-5 lead. You know what? We got to jump on board with Captain Anik. He was just going nuts. Just as I switched him, he was taken down. But he just picked up three straight kills. He is leading his team. And I'll be honest, Nexi, after watching that first game, Captain Anarchy, you know, he may be playing the best for Carbon right now.
He's playing on another level. We've never seen him play at this high of a caliber before. I mean, if you're Captain Anarchy's teammate, you have to be proud of him right now because you know he's doing a major part to win these games.
You know, and maybe it's something having his mom here in the audience. Miss Anarchy here in the house tonight. She is here to cheer on her son. Met her earlier, and she was just telling me how proud of him after watching his games last night. We're jumping right back in board with Captain Anarchy as he is setting up top here of the towers. Now, this is something that we've seen a lot out of Carbon over the course of the season. Didn't matter who the teammates were. You'd see Ghost Yami or anyone else on the team set one person up on the tower, and then they'd spread the others around the perimeter.
Well, Ghost Yami taught us himself the night he came into the office and we gamed all night. He told us, you got to get up high, you got to be able to catch the other team off a spawn, and you'll see him do it right here.
Well, right now we have Straight Rippin' on a little bit of a roll here. They were down by about six kills, but now they've cut the lead to just four. And 2legit is going to get spawned on by Nated. And we're going to Captain Anarchy. He's in a great position, top middle, but he's got to wait for his teammates to do some distraction fire because three of them were dead momentarily. 23-18, though, Carbon holding on to a lead. Ooh, and Captain Anarchy is being taken down. Meanwhile, Goseami doing some big damage here. And we are going to listen in with this Carbon team. These guys are going nuts.
Watch you guys.
Heal my warrior. Don't get trapped. Red 2.
Jeez.
Red 2 also.
Front of red.
P2,
red
one
two,
shot.
Red 2, one shield.
P2,
one shot, guys.
No shields.
Charging P3 right now.
He's dead.
Red 2.
My base. Blue 2.
Above you, Lux.
Above me?
Yep, he was there.
He got shot.
One shot. Nice. Keep it up, guys. Keep it up. We're keeping up with big lead.
Front of red. No shields.
I got him.
Nice job.
Blue. And gold 2, guys. Gold 2.
Gold 1
and gold. Bound it all out.
Listen to each other, guys. Start listening.
He's charging.
Go on.
Keep it up! I'm underneath you, Carlos.
I need help kickside, guys.
I'm here.
Literally.
Where'd he go?
Right in front of you, dude.
D1.
Bottom middle, one shot, Chris.
Yeah, I died. Give peace side.
Yeah, I'm on tower also.
Guys,
two on my tower.
Guys, slow down. I'm getting killed from gold. Red 2 spawn.
One shot of legit.
Red 2 spawn.
Two guys, P1. Get him off top
right now. Watch next to you.
Behind us, guys.
Bottom mid. Front of mid.
And gold 1.
Gold 1 still.
I'm one shot.
Gold 1, 2 legit. Gold 1, 2 legit.
No shields.
Down. Two down, guys. Keep it up.
Red 2. All over it.
Nice kill.
Blue 2. One shot, Blue 2. We killed each other. Pink side on Eric.
Shutdown going nuts here in NetSeek. You gotta check this out. He is on a 6-kill streak. Make that 7, hitting the long-range shots across the map. Just tied up the score here for Straight Rippin. And now they take the lead here as Too Legit and Snipedown are working perfectly together. And now Snipedown with another perfect 4-shot. If he gets one or two more kills, he will have a killing frenzy. He's taken down, but we cannot switch from his screen. He just went absolutely off. He's leading all players with 15 kills right now.
Check it out. When Snipedown heats up, his team gets back into it. They tied it up. Snipedown ran around, and he went nuts. And now his team's back into that. Huge props to Snipedown on the play.
Yeah, he single-handedly brought his team right back into this match.
Well, you know what? It's 8 kills for either team here. Carbon's going to retake the lead with 43. Whoever can capitalize at the end. And Snipedown's grenade catches the wall, and he's taken out. We're jumping back over to Carbon. It's all tied up, 44 to 44. Shockwave getting attacked by 3 members from Straight Rippin, and Elamite Warrior is going to beat him down. And now Shockwave trying to chase down Snipedown.
Snipedown getting close.
48 to 47. This one could go either way. We saw Instinct lose last minute to Final Boss, but Straight Rippin is looking to take this one, and there we go. Wow, what an amazing game out of Snipedown.
And his clutch performance paved the way for Straight Rippin to knock Carbon down to the loser's bracket. Now the final score there was 3-2, and Carbon will go on to the loser's bracket to face Instinct in game 1, Onslaught, Capture the Flag. And we're back here live, and look at this exciting crowd going crazy. Everything is coming to the peak here right now, and they have reason to be excited down there in the stands. And we've got a great matchup here in the Losers Bracket Finals between Carbon and Instinct. They need no introduction, but let's meet the teams.
That's right, Farouk. It's our Losers Bracket Finals. The winner, of course, is going to go on to play Straight Rippin' in the championship match. We're taking a look at the red team. It's Instinct, Lunchbox, Roy, Team Captain Walshy, and of course, Soviet.
All right, and we've already touched on these a couple of times today. The keys to success, the twin clutchness. Roy's having the tournament of his life right now, and he's bringing it at the right time. Soviet also doing big things. They've been winning the Team Slayers. That's why they're here. If they continue to dominate the objective game types, they'll be just fine.
And then, of course, Sundance, they got to look out because the guys on the other side of the stage, they've been pulling off upsets all weekend long. We're taking a look at the blue team. It's Carbon. And these guys, they had a really close series against Straight Rippin and Shockwave. His BR was absolutely solid, stopping flags time and time again. Ghost Yami, he was clutch, but Captain Anarchy definitely had one of his best series we've seen out of him all season long. And, of course, Naden, he's on top of his game with the sniper rifle.
Yeah, we've been talking about this all day long, too. They've got to be clutch, and they've done that so far. They almost got past Straight Rippin. They've been keeping their heads in the game because they're having fun, and that's key for them. The teamwork's been great. They've been slaying pretty well, but most importantly, Shockwave has been like Shockwave of old, leading his team and having a good time. And when he does that, the rest of the guys feed off of him. If he has a big match this time around against Instinct, they're going to do very well. Look at him smiling.
All right, so here we go. We're just going to go ahead and get this one started. I'm tired of waiting. Gears of War is over. It's time to get back in the Halo 3 world. Capture the Flag Onslaught will be the first of the best of 5 series. Of course, the first team to score 5 flags will win the game. We're going to a 15-minute time limit, and we're going to start this one off with Walshy. So the team captain of Instinct going up here on B-side. Meanwhile, it looks like Roy is going to go up on A-side. Meanwhile, Soviet is down bottom A. And Walshy, taking a little bit of damage, is going to wait for his teammates to push in first. Soviet's going to pick up a big kill on Shockwave. All 4 down for Carbon to start this game. Instinct off to an amazing start. And now they're establishing map control with a flag already in the hands of Soviet. And this is what Instinct did earlier in the tournament. They come out firing here on Onslaught, but a nice push here by the guys from Carbon as they're able to stop that first flag attempt.
We're gonna jump on board now with Naden. He was one of the players clutch there to stop the flag. Now trying to get into the instant base. He's taken down. The rest of his teammates are dead except for this player right here. It is Captain Anarchy, and he is at the instant base. Sundance, what are you expecting out of this opening game? What do we need to see for a team here to catch the momentum going into this loser's bracket? I'm excited.
Of course you are, with good reason. Well, you know, the thing about this game type is Instinct does exceptionally well with this lineup. They're 4-0 on it because they're so disruptive. You see right there, they get the first flag cap. These guys are always around your flag. You've always got to pay attention to your base, but they're not just going to pull the flag at the wrong time. They're going to wait until they have an advantage. They're going to use the clock very well. They know how long it takes to get across the map. They know how long the respawns are, so they're going to wait until they've got some momentum. But for them, it's not about being, you know, two or three guys up. They'll pull it when they're down a guy or down two guys, because that's part of their strategy on this map, is shock and awe. They want to keep you off balance.
All right, now who's going to be the key player for Instinct? Who's going to be the key player for Carbon in your mind?
Well, in my mind, you know, I think it's going to hinge on Roy again, because he's the guy who's going to be laying down fire all over the place. If Instinct is going to do well in this game, I expect to see him with a ton of kills. He will touch the flag on occasion, but most importantly, he's just got to be using that BR. Now, on the other side, I look for Ghost Naomi. Well, Naden has been having a strong tournament. I really think in this game type, Ghost Naomi's got to be clutch for them, mixing it up, both touching flags and getting kills. If he's able to do that, that's going to be great, a good sign for his team.
And as we mentioned last night on ESPN Saturday night, Ghost Naomi is one of the best and fastest flag runners on this circuit, if not the fastest. And here we go, Instinct already putting in a second flag after 2 minutes and 30 seconds off the clock. The crowd here getting animated. You see standing room only here.
Roy
and
with a big double kill right there.
He's going off right now, Sundance. He's got the double kill. He's
getting
got
the kills
middle.
And he's running the flag. He actually ran that flag all the way back for his team right there. And that's the great thing about them, is that it's interchangeable parts. Everybody does a great job at whatever it's called, they're called upon to do at any given time.
All right, well, right now we are checking out Walshy. He's putting big shots there on Ghost Naomi, clearing out Ghost Naomi out of the power position on this map. Being top middle is probably the most dangerous position you can be. You can fire down on both of the respawns as well as being able to watch the flags. But right now we have Team Carbon trying to move a flag down low. Instinct's Lunchbox is trying to make a stop, and finally he's able to take down Captain Anarchy, but three of his teammates are down, so it's all up to Lunchbox. He does get the return, and now he's going to wait for his teammates to come back him up before he pushes in for another flag attempt here for Instinct.
Now the thing about this map, as we know, we've seen it so many times, you can get out to an early lead, but it's so easy for teams to grab a couple of quick caps if you're not careful, if you overextend yourself. And Instinct very lucky right there that they weren't overextended, able to get that return, but also not find themselves in a position where Carbon members were in their base, ready to pull the flag again.
All right, well, right now, Walshy's pulling the flag, but I'm going to go to Soviet. He is going to be Walshy's lead blocker. He's going to be the player trying to stop all of Carbon from taking out his teammates coming off the respawn, but it looks like Carbon doing a nice job fighting out of those spawn traps that Instinct tried to set up. And Soviet, he is taking all kinds of damage from grenades here down in front of the base. He's finally going to be taken out. Let's switch over to a member from Carbon. I want to check out Captain Anarchy. As I mentioned in the intro Sunday, Captain Anarchy had one of his best games of the season, putting up 34 kills against Straight Rippin'. Anarchy's taken down, and the rest of the squad still getting spawn played. But what have you seen out of Captain Anarchy that has been different here in Vegas than what we've seen in the past tournament so far this season?
Well, I mean, honestly, it's been an A game. I mean, Anarchy's got ability. He's been on the circuit for quite a while. He's been on top teams before, had a stint on Straight Rippin', but we just haven't seen him step up this season. The guys on Carbon talked about how great he was in practice, but that never seemed to translate to the live events here on the pro circuit. But this event, maybe it's his mom being here, as you were saying earlier, something about his gameplay has been sparked. It's not that he's going huge for his team every single game, but he's doing the little things, and then mixing in going huge for his teammates. Like right here, this play, very aggressive, but it's working for him.
You gotta love it. He jumped off the top middle structure there, jumping off the wall, getting all the way into the opponent's base, and then quickly grabbing that flag, taking it all the way back to his base. So right now, we got Shockwave, the team captain, picking up a huge double kill with an assassination, and he's gonna put in the flag. It is now 2-1. Carbon showing some life there on the scoreboard now.
Yeah, and just like that, they're in a good position here. And flag is out again for Instinct. So
we got a big double kill out of Captain Anarchy, Sundance. Ghost Naomi is going to be moving the flag now.
This
so Instinct
dangerous.
Has got to be cautious. And of course, we got Ghost Naomi moving that flag right into his base right now.
Oh, he's
here
so
is
good
the
with
tying
it.
Capture.
Boom. And that's what we're talking about. Two caps in under a minute. Carbon right back in this. And again, it's all about momentum. You saw Instinct out to the early lead, looking solid. But Carbon, seemingly against all odds right there, just gets two really quick caps. And now they've got to be feeling solid.
Look where Ghost is standing. We rarely see this. And this is hopefully going to catch people from Instinct off guard a bit. But instead, Ghost Yami moving into that power position. As we discussed earlier, top middle, he saw Lunchbox down low. Lunchbox was the threat. He stopped the flag momentarily, and now it's going to be up to Ghost to run it. But a nice grenade takes him down. So we're jumping on board with Captain Anarchy. Anarchy trying to move the flag down low. And it looks like the spawn sling is still going to continue. Ghost Yami is going to put that flag in. Carbon, they are clicking on all cylinders right now.
They are really having the event of the season right now. They're just playing so well together. It shouldn't be shocking anymore, but it is. They're not letting up. We
got to go check this out, Sundance. You got to check out Ghost Yami right now. Shockwave was in the base with Captain Anarchy. Spawn sling instinct incredibly hard. Ghost Yami going down low, but you know, Naden, he's been doing big things as well. He just killed three people on Instinct's respawn, trying to fight out of his own respawn trap now, because we have Instinct now moving the flag. They're going to be able to counter and hopefully get a bit of momentum going back in their favor. We're going to jump on board with Lunchbox, but a nice play there by Captain Anarchy and Shockwave, once again working as a tandem to stop that cap. Oh, and now this is just a massacre right here. I'm going to lay out, and we're just going to watch Shockwave here for a minute. He had a few clutch plays that sparked two of those three opening flag caps here for Carbon. But Instinct, you know, they came out of the gate super strong, up 2-1. And now it seems that they're giving up a little bit of the momentum here to Instinct. What's going on?
Well, I don't know that it's that they're giving it up. It seems more to me like Carbon got warm again, and they're just taking it back. I was talking to Gandhi during the last round a little bit. And he was telling me that the big difference with Shockwave's game was the decisions he was making. He was making smart decisions as opposed to charging in on his own as he used to be able to in Halo 2. He was laying back, taking good routes to flags, taking good routes to back up his teammates. And we're seeing more of that so far in this CTF game. If he continues to do that, as I said, it makes his other teammates more confident that they can do what they need to do and play within their game.
Well, right now we got a flag in the hands of Soviet. He got it all the way back to his base. Shockwave, the only player alive for Carbon, in position to stop it, and Roy is going to put that one in. So it's all tied up 3-3. Instinct showing some life once again as they're able to convert a flag capture. And we're going to jump right on board with Captain Anarchy. They are not backing down from this Instinct squad. They will not stop putting the pressure on them, and they keep charging the Instinct respawn. But Instinct, they're just doing a great job right now of fighting out of those spawn traps. And then after fighting out of those spawn traps, they are turning these situations into flag captures of their own.
And look who, during that engagement, was sneaking into the other base. Walshy. While all the Instinct guys were engaged with Carbon, Walshy slides around, pulls a flag, boom, 4-3.
All right, well, Walshy doing the dirty right now here from top middle. Meanwhile, you saw Roy was on that B side of the map doing some damage on the Carbon respawns. But now with Walshy's backup down here on B side, he's going to have to play a bit sneakier. And it pays off as he takes down Captain Anarchy. And now he's going to try and help out Lunchbox and Soviet bottom middle. Oh, but Shockwave comes up big there, shooting from top A. And now you see Shockwave, he was top A, comes all the way back to his own flag to make sure that Instinct does not get the fifth and final flag capture here. Meanwhile, you got Captain Anarchy, LO5 there, and Naded, they are pushing into the base from A side. And Shockwave's going to get hit by an unlucky grenade. We're jumping on board with Naden. He is still staying sneaky, staying alive here. Bottom of A base here for the Instinct side of the map.
I get the feeling that Carver's going to pull this one out. We're going to have to see more out of Naden.
The flag is out for Instinct. Shockwave trying to push it down bottom middle, but it looked like they were really just trying to force it here. But you know what? Forcing it may have worked out. Shockwave distracting just long enough as they pass to Ghost Yami. Once again, Captain Anarchy and Ghost Yami. What a great flag capping tandem we've seen so far.
That
this
was
game.
Fantastic. And again, Nated didn't get both of the kills, but he was up in the base disrupting. And it's just Carbon right now, not so willing to say die, staying in this at 4-4.
And after Carbon capped those Sundance, I want to point this out. The whole crowd out here started chanting Instinct. So it looks like the crowd
definitely more Instinct fans than there are Carbon fans, and hopefully for the Instinct guys, if you're an Instinct fan watching from home, that'll get them fired up. And the one player who looks like he's getting fired up right now, it would be Roy.
All right, so you see now Roy here watching Spawn while his teammate runs flag.
Twin brother Lunchbox running the flag down bottom A side. Roy looking to pick up some kills, and here we go, the final flag, and there it is. Instinct is going to take game one. What an awesome game there. Carbon, they had an awesome tournament, but you know, Farouk, they really were no match for an incredibly talented Instinct roster.
And in the championship match, Instinct came in down 3-2. They took the first game of the continuation to tie it all up, but Straight Ripping came right back, winning the next two, which set us up for game number 9, Onslaught CTF.
And there you have it right there. Great players, great respect and admiration for each other, leading to a great team, Puckett and Sundance.
Yeah, and you know, we got a great series going on as well. It's 5-3 right now. This next game type is a strong suit for Instinct, though. They play really well CTF Onslaught, so this is going to be interesting. Straight Ripping got their work cut out for them if they're going to win this next game. And Instinct, of course, they're down, but they're not out. So I'm looking for big things out of those guys.
All right, well, Sundance, it's time to find out, is it all going to end with this game, or is there going to be more? We are going right into the next game. It is going to be a big game 9 here. It is CTF Onslaught, my favorite game type out of the 11. Sundance, as you mentioned earlier, Instinct, they're perfect in it since Toronto. Time to see if they can keep it up. We're going to jump on board with Legit.
Got one.
Legit taking down. We're jumping on board with Snipe Down.
He's in there somewhere.
Snipe Down being taken down at Instinct base. We're gonna go on board with Roy. Roy is trying to climb his way top B, and I am trying not to sneeze. I fought it off, and here we go. Roy is moving top middle, people. I am excited.
Put the little finger under your nose right there. Woo. But yeah, going from Snipe Down to Roy, I mean, I'm sitting here looking at the stats, and I check it out and see that Roy so far in this tournament is going plus 63, but Snipe Down in one less matchup has gone plus 74. I mean, these guys, these two of the best guys in kills going positive in this tournament, and they're displaying truly professional Halo 3 play right here.
Of course, you got to remember that game earlier in the tournament last night on ESPN Saturday Night, where Snipe Down put up 44 kills, only 20 deaths in that long CTF pit match. But now we are watching as all four members of Instinct are taken down, and this is the first flag attempt out of either team. It's going in the hands of Elmite Warrior. He was holding onto that flag as long as possible. Now he's jumping it around, trying to get it in his base. He's going to get shut down. T-squared trying to make his way over to it because Legit just sprung a big double kill bottom middle. And here comes T-squared to support. And if they get that kill, yes, double. They do. Nice work, and Legit is going to be able to put in this first flag of the game. Here goes Straight Ripping.
And not only do they put it in, but they're not in a position for a counter cap to be sprung by Instinct. All four were aligned at the moment that flag went in. That's great execution. Legit taking his time, not rushing. Good job right there. Patience. It's all about patience sometimes, especially in an objective game.
And once again, I just got to point out how big that double kill was out of Legit. Absolutely huge. It was a two-on-one situation. He took them both out with a perfect grenade. And now we got Elmite Warrior trying to keep this flag alive, but it is not going to happen because Walshy is there inside the Straight Ripping base.
Now remember, we've seen it before on this map, this game type, that the team can get a cap very, very quickly. And here's Walshy.
And you know what, Sundance? If they score this one, they may be set up to get a second flag cap. So Walshy trying to stay alive in his base. He was shooting across the map, Straight Ripping doing a nice job fighting off a second flag cap, clearing out their base with three players dead. And now Walshy waiting on Straight Ripping to push in on him, and it's Snipe Down in front of him, but three nice shots on Snipe Down, but two Legit is coming in from behind, and now Legit is moving a second flag cap here.
Four straight ripping. Misses his first jump. Rarely misses that, and Elmite Warrior is going to put it in as Legit goes right back to the floor. Straight ripping up now, 2-1 in this objective game, and Straight Ripping is going to keep the pressure here on Instinct.
I like this by Straight Ripping, not letting up, being aggressive, knowing they've got the 2-flag lead right now. Look for Instinct to be, but start to be more of a pass. We may pull the flag more frequently because they needed to do some distraction here. They need to find some rhythm. Maybe pulling that flag will help them out. The more touches you get, the more confident you get. They're going to need to do something here. Down 2-1. Definitely not out of it, but right now just having a tough time getting any rhythm.
Of course, Sunez has the 1-flag lead, 2-game lead here in the championship match. Straight Ripping just 1 game away from becoming our 2008 Halo 3 national champion. Soviet trying to make sure that doesn't happen. Picking up the kill on Snipedown. Now moving in for a second kill on Elmite Warrior. Roy is there set up to do some spawn slaying with the help of Walshy. And now Lunchbox is coming off the respawn on the perfect side of the map to help out Soviet with this flag. And Snipedown, the only player in position to put shots there on the flag. And there we go. Roy is going to put it in. No, he does not. And Lunchbox will. The twin brother puts it in. So it is all tied up 2-2. We are keeping this one rolling here because T-Squared was in the Instinct base. But he is going to be taken down. So Lunchbox right now picking up the assassination bottom middle. Now jumping up top middle, going for the new flag. Picks up the beatdown, now picking up the double kill. So Instinct going for a third flag cap here in the game. And Lunchbox, he is going absolutely off right now. He just put in a flag, picked up 3 kills on his way over to the next flag, and then did a whole lot of damage to get the flag all the way back to his base. Can Soviet put this flag in, or will Elmite Warrior get the return? Elmite goes down, but T-Squared is there. So Straight Ripping clutching it, and now T-Squared and crew are going to try a counter cap, but Snipedown has to lead the way, picking up a few spawn kills, and he cannot do it, and T-Squared is going to be stopped. We're going to jump on board with Elmite Warrior, though, because he is going to keep the flag alive through bottom B-side. He is now moving it into the base. A 2-2 game right here, and Elmite is going to be stopped. Soviet this time around getting the flag return, and he is going to stop Straight Ripping. Instinct coming right back at him. And so now Instinct moving the flag, bottom A side, trying to keep it alive in the hands of Walshy. Walshy goes down, but Roy has a big double kill, trying to fight off the remaining two members. T-Squared is top A, and Legit was down bottom middle.
What a play by Legit.
And Legit with the triple kill, Sundance. Wow, this kid goes clutch.
You know, listen to you call that game, that action right there. Fucking, I was getting all caught up into it. Soviet with a huge play, Legit with a huge play. These guys are going at it. They're both bringing their A game, and I love to see that. You never want to see a championship series determined by one team because they don't play their best. These guys right now are putting it all out there, and that's what we love to see here on the MLG Pro Circuit.
8 of the best Halo 3 players in the world facing off right now for $100,000. Legit moving the third flag for Straight Ripping. They just need 2 more flags until they become the 2008 national champions. But Instinct, they are not going down without a fight here. And Elmite Warrior coming off the double kill. He is going to be taken down at the Instinct base. Now it is Snipedown trying to sneak over to the Instinct's A side. And Snipedown continues to kill. Soviet charging him, and he goes for the stick, but Snipedown is going to be taken out. We're jumping on board with Elmite Warrior. Elmite with the big kill on Lunchbox, moving bottom B. All of his team fighting off the Instinct squad, though, who are rushing in quite quickly. So 2 are down right now for Instinct. Lunchbox and Soviet trying to stay alive as Walshy is going to be picked off. And Lunchbox is going to go down as well. So here goes Straight Ripping. They're going for this 4th flag cap. It's in the hands of Legit. He was the only member alive, but just as he gets to his base, his teammates spawn, and he jumped over it with the grenade. Snipedown goes down as well. T-Squared, can he get to the flag in time? And he picks up the big kill on Roy, but it looks like Lunchbox is going to get his flag out. Instinct with another clutch return. Lunchbox getting the flag down far. Soviet trying to keep the flag alive by spawn killing. Meanwhile, Walshy is putting this flag in his base. Yes, so it is now 3-3, all tied up.
How crazy of a turnaround is that, where he just overjumped the flag, couldn't cap, and then instinct comes right back with a counter cap, tying it up, and it could have been 4-2.
It was
that
a perfect grenade.
Just blew him right past. I mean, you know what? That's the whole thing. That's why you see these players lobbing grenades. They know where you're going. You know, sometimes you gotta wait a second, you gotta take your time, but they couldn't. He had to try and get that cap.
You know, Farouk, it was a desperation grenade, and it paid off for the Instinct squad, and now they're trying to capitalize on that momentum shift. We got Soviet in the base. He continues to slay with the help of Roy. Roy really heating it up with the battle rifle. You saw Soviet going huge, picking up the double kill. That allowed Walshy to put that last flag cap in, and now Soviet somehow staying alive, fumbles the flag and grenades himself.
Oh man, that is a big mistake right there.
And you know, I was talking to Triple X, he said Soviet, sometimes an emotional player, he cannot let that affect him. He has to stay focused in this game. And Lunchbox, he's gonna still try and keep this flag alive, but Legit is gonna be there, and Legit is gonna win that VR battle.
And as you talk about Triple X there, Puckett, I just saw life get breathed right into Triple X, because he was standing there with a hand behind his back. Then when they tied it up with that flag cap that Walshy had, he came out, his hands is out, he's ready, he's getting his team back into this.
All right, well, forward down momentarily there for Instinct. But here comes Soviet. He got three kills on the straight ripping squad. Now looking for a fourth here on Elmite Warrior spawn. Soviet's VR is perfect right now.
Ooh, taken out right there.
But Walshy's still on. All right, so Instinct. Three of the members being taken down, sniped out, moving the flag, bottom middle.
Oh my.
The flag still moving. Elmite Warriors got it on the base. And all of Straight Ripping freaking out, but it looks like Walshy is going to be able to get the return. And now Walshy from Instinct is going to be able to stop that flag cap. And now trying to counter with a flag cap of his own. Roy's got to pick up a few huge kills here. But no, it looks like Straight Ripping is going to be able to make a flag return. All four Legit dead once again here for Instinct.
And Legit did a great job right there. You guys at home couldn't see, but he waited top middle, watched Walshy go underneath him, drop down behind him, got the kill, got the return. Huge play out of Legit. Clutch right there, not freaking out, knowing exactly where his opponent was, and coming up with that huge stop.
Well, all eight of these players playing at the top of the game. The greatest Halo we have seen yet, Sundance. 3-3, all tied up. 4 minutes left in regulation time. If it's tied up, we will go to sudden death overtime, as we have seen time and time again in this event so far. Now Soviet versus Legit. Legit stays alive. Snipe down trying to come in and clean up the kill, and Soviet almost out VR'd him. But right now we have a flag moving in the hands of Straight Ripping. Elmite Warrior has it going back towards his base. He's hiding in the maze, trying to let his shields respond, hoping that his teammates can pick up a few huge kills. Here's Legit getting the beatdown, but it looks like Instinct is going to be able to pick up the flag return.
Walshy coming up clutch there again, time and time again. It doesn't matter. Every time somebody looks like they're going to get across the map, Straight Ripping in his last couple of flag pulls, somebody comes up huge. Either Soviet, Walshy, Roy, Lunchbox, you name it. They're all trading out, coming up with huge clutch plays.
And they're all taking turns, Sundance, as you mentioned. And here we are watching Lunchbox. He is trying to make his turn count as he picks up a big beatdown on Elmite Warrior. Roy was trying to move the flag, but a nice grenade there by Elmite is going to stop his progress. And Lunchbox just continuing to spawn slaughter now. But somehow T-Squared was able to escape. He was able to get top A. And now we are going to check out as Soviet is going to get wrecked as well. Roy, the last member alive from Instinct, has to stay alive right here. He cannot allow Straight Ripping to set up.
And T-Squared did a good job right there. He's hanging out, getting position for his teammates.
Yeah, probably
I'm going in.
RB box. I'm not gonna run
again. Here we go. Roy behind all of Straight Ripping. The rest of Straight Ripping at his base trying to set up. Snipe down knew he was here, and now they're coming in after Roy. Roy is taken down, but he bought enough time for Soviet to escape out of the spawn trap. And now Soviet making that work. He's capitalizing on it. He's moving the flag bottom middle, going for the straight shot. We've seen Legit do it. And now he's gonna do it. So Instinct takes the lead with 2 minutes left in regulation time.
perfect execution.
Play out of Soviet right there. You mentioned earlier, Funkin, that sometimes he gets a little bit emotional. Obviously not letting that glove from earlier get into his head too much right there. Huge cap right there. Given Instinct a 4-3 lead. The time about to expire here. Only a minute 50 left in regulation.
And you know what? That is going to put the pressure right back on Straight Rippin'. Oh, and Legit is going to get spawned upon. We're jumping right back on board with Soviet from Instinct. They're moving the fifth and final flag is moving in the hands of Roy. Soviet set up top middle. And Soviet set up to keep spawn killing. Meanwhile, Roy, he's got the flag, but there is a huge beatdown by T-Squared. Captain Clutch for T2. And T2 makes the flag return. That was absolutely huge. Great assassination. But now, Straight Rippin' coming for the counter, Sundance, but they only have 1:10 left on the clock, and Legit and T-Squared are the only two members alive right now.
What now, remember, if that flag is out, when we reach the end of regulation, we're going to continue to play until it returns. So being in a position to pull that flag near the end of regulation is something that Straight Rippin' might want to think about. Right now, they got to go balls to the wall, though, because there's not a lot of time left.
And that's what I was going to ask you. What do you do here in this situation if your Instinct? Do you protect your flag, or do you still keep attacking?
You go for the final cap.
Yeah.
You finish
gotta
strong.
Try and close it out.
Otherwise, Straight Rippin' will go for your jugular, and they will get it, Farouk. And here we got El Might Warrior going exactly for that. He's got the flag, fumbling it off the wall, but a great recovery here, and he's got SmackDown at the base with him. Here we go, Straight Rippin', your 2008 Halo 3 National Champions. Oh, wait, not yet, Sundance. It's only tied up 4-4.
You're crazy, my man. Well, Funkin's giving away the championship. I want to see how this is going to end. Next cap wins. Legit's got the flag out right here. Instinct fighting for their lives, going for the cap. Straight Rippin's got to be worried about the counter cap. Oh my goodness, folks. This could
be it.
El Might
Warrior.
Oh.
I'm letting you call it this time, Sundance.
Oh, and
Legit.
We've got
a
new champion. Now, T2, I've known you for a long time. I remember when you first came into the league. How you feeling right now, man?
I'm great. I feel great, man. I'm so happy how my team pulled together. That last game was awesome. I couldn't ask for it to end any other way. Instinct's a great team. Walsh's a great captain. And I'm glad that they got that far.
Well, congratulations again. And as you mentioned, Instinct doing big things. Big congratulations to them. But tell me, you guys, you went through a lot this season, obviously. You came into the season as the number one team after the online ladders. You're closing out the season as number one. I know this is something you've wanted your whole career. How much does this mean to you personally as a player and as a captain?
It means a lot. I mean, I'm lost for words right now. It's all your hard work finally pays off. It's probably the best feeling in the world. It really is.
Well, you know what? I've seen a lot of Halo, and I want to thank you guys for an amazing performance. SnipeDown, Elamite, Legit, T-Squared, Straight Rippin', your 2008 MLG Halo 3 champions.
What an incredible game. Farouk, I lost it at the end there. I called it early, but in the end, Straight Rippin' prevailed as the 2008 Halo 3 National Champions and walking home with $100,000.
And this was the most exciting national championships we've ever had at MLG, and what a way to end the 2008 season. Thank you for watching the Best of Vegas 2008. For Chris Puckett, I'm Farouk Tahid. We'll see you next season.